हेलो एवरीवन, मैं चल डॉक्टर रवि नारायण खाड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, लेट पुष्पादेवी पाटिल आर्ट्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज, रिसोड, डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाशिम। टुडे आई विल गिव टू गेस्ट लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक एक्वाटिक अडेप्टेशन इन एनिमल्स। दिस गेस्ट लेक्चर आर ऑल्सो ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय लेट पुंडलिकराव गवळी आर्ट्स एंड साइंस महाविद्यालय शिरपूर जैन तालुका मालेगाव डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाशिम। दिस अपॉर्च्युनिटी ऑल्सो गिव मी असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर मिस्टर वरुण लोहिया सर। आई एम रियली थैंकफुल टू सच वंडरफुल प्रोग्राम of guest lecture series also organized by their college principal, the Dr. Pokhare sir. I am really thankful to Pokhare sir and my respected guru, head and assistant professor Sachin Taide sir, and my respected madam Dr. Jaya Sobatkar madam, assistant professor from the late Pundalikrao Gowri Arts and Science Mahavidyalaya Shirpur. So today my topic is aquatic adaptations in animals. First of all, animal adaptations means any change in organism which make it slowly or rapidly better to its environment are called animal adaptation. We can also define as in another way the structural, physiological and behavioral features, or we can say that the behavioral features that organism develop which enable them to survive and reproduce successfully in the environment. Okay, or simply we can say that it gives the process to adjustment of organism to their surrounding habitat. Is the organism which are adjustable to their surrounding habitats, that terms we can say that adaptation, or that organism we can say organism with organism also called as animal adaptations. Okay, in animal adaptation in your syllabus include the desert adaptation, aquatic adaptation, terrestrial adaptation, but now it will be discussed the aquatic adaptation. This is the structural adaptation. It relames one of the most important habitat where a large number of animals also present or live. The adaptation to water habitat are of two types: primary aquatic adaptation and secondary aquatic adaptations. First of all, in this detail discuss the primary aquatic adaptations. Here the animal which are inhabitant to water never live on land. They respire through the gill, show the primary aquatic adaptation. Their ancestors are living in water, not live or never live on land. For example, just fishes, they are the perfect aquatic adaptation. So they show the perfect aquatic adaptation. Or they evolved in water and never had terrestrial ancestry. They show the following different features: streamlined body. Each and every fish, they show their body structure in streamlined shape because they avoid that streamlined body also avoid water resistance during swimming. Fins acts as a paddle to slow and balance the body while changing direction. Scale protect the body from external injury. Swim bladder acts as a hydrostatic organs to float on the water surface and also serve as a respiratory accessory organs. Skin with mucous gland, that is the they show the slippery skin, help to escape away from predator and also save from fungal infection. Then lateral line system, it acts as a receptor to detect physical and chemical change in water, nictitating membrane to protect eye from the dirt present in water, osmoregulations that maintain the water and salt content in the body. Okay, this is all about the primary aquatic features. Then secondary aquatic adaptation, they show the various feature. First of all, we talk about the secondary aquatic adaptations. Animal which live on land due to some circumstances such as scarcity of food, unfavorable climate, or risks of predator, etc. They compelled to live in water and lung through the breath is a secondary adaptation. That is the example is turtle. Adaptations of secondary aquatic, they show the various features. Streamlined body, same, they avoid the water resistance during swimming. Large and spongy skeleton, float on water surface. Modification limbs are modified according to their habitats. Turtle has paddles like limb to swim. Respiration, they respire through the lung. Nostrils are closed by muscular flaps during swimming, which prevent the entry of water through the nostrils. Absence of hair and skin gland. In place of hair and skin gland, fat deposited under subcutaneous layer acts as a thermoinsulator. This is all about the aquatic adaptation in animals. Thanks. Once again, I am really thankful to Mr. Varun Lovia, sir. They give me the opportunity to deliver a guest lecture. Then I am really thankful to my first guru, Dr. Taide sir, who is a head and assistant professor. And I am really thankful to my teacher, my madam, Jaya Sobatkar, assistant professor. And I am really thankful to respected principal, Dr. Fokale sir. They give me the also permission or chance to deliver a guest lecture. Thanks to all of you.